Hello and welcome back. We are continuing with our free training series for beginners, and now we are starting the second section from our lessons. I hope you find the first section very interesting and useful for you, and if you have any questions, you can leave them below every video and you'll respond to them, and of course you can contact with any of us directly. As you know, we are DM Training Bulgaria, this is our team, and if you want to learn more about us, you can check everything on our website that I'm showing you here. So, from the introduction, you're already familiar with the plan, and now we are in section 2, technical analysis, and today's lesson will be about market trends. So, the trends on the markets, what are they and how they look like? Well, the simplest explanation is that the market trends are continuous movement on either the long side or the short side. As you may remember from the previous lessons, movement on the long side means that the price is going up, and movement on the downside means that the price is going down. We are defining the trends in several categories. First, there is an uptrend, then there is a downtrend, and of course there is a range as well. In a minute, I'll show you illustrations on how this formation looks like, but first I want to add something about the range. You can find it also under the name consolidation or square formation, but it doesn't really matter, because in my opinion they are representing one and the same thing. The price is standing on one and the same level and it's expecting the next impulse. So now let's continue. This illustration is representing the movement of the price for an uptrend. As you can see, the price is constantly rising and the highs are always higher than the previous one. And of course, this is stands for the lows as well. As you can see, the lows are always higher than the previous one as well. But we are going to speak more about that and in more details in a few slides. Now, let's continue with the downtrend. As you can see, this is representing the movement of the price in a downtrend. What you can observe here is that the price is again fluctuating, but the constant movement is on the downside, or with other words, the price is just dropping. Here again, it is very important to remember that the highs are lower than the previous one and the lows are again lower than the previous one as well. Now it is time for the range or rectangle square formation. As you can see, this movement is representing when the price is bouncing between some borders, but in the end of the day, the price is just going sideways. With other words, neither the buyers or the sellers are taking the lead. They are just exchanging orders on one and the same level. Most often this appears when the price is expecting something which it can be news or a break of a certain level. It doesn't really matter. The main thing is that everyone are waiting for the big impulse and the confirmation in which way the price will go. Here I'm going to show you on a real chart examples for a range, up and downtrend of course. But first, I would like to ask you if you want to pause this video for just several seconds and try to define and find by yourself what could be a range, up and downtrend, and then we're going to see them all together. So, I hope you managed to find some examples of this formation, and if you haven't, don't worry, that's why we are all learning now. So, let's continue with the examples and see them all together. First is the range. As you can see, the price is moving between these borders and it's bounding from the downside and the upside of the range, and in the end it is breaking the range. And what's next? Well, the continuation is the beginning of an uptrend, as you can see now. During the uptrend, as you can see, the price is making small corrections here, here and here, but the main movement is on the long side, or with other words, the price is just going up. And what's next? Well, it is the downtrend. As you can see, the price is constantly dropping. Of course, there are several corrections here and here, but the main movement is on the short side. So, what's next is that the trend is your friend. In my opinion, this is very important for you to remember, because the easiest way to make money is when you're following the trend. In a minute, I will going to show you a real chart on which we are going to see what are the main advantages and disadvantages when you're following the trend. As you can see from the chart, this is the metal palladium. This is actually one of my favorite methods, and the chart is on a daily time frame. Here, the main advantage is that you can basically buy and open a long trade on every correction that the price is making, that I'm showing to you now, and on paper. In this way, you're going to generate money constantly and in relatively short period of time. And also, with this approach, when you're following the trade, the probability for your trades to be profitable is also higher, because in this way you're following the main movement and you're going with the biggest buyers on the market. Of course, if you want to implement this approach and to go on the short side, this is again possible, as you can see here. I don't know if you can see it properly, but the situation is the same, just you're going with the rules vice versa. You're just selling on every upside of the price and you're going with the main sellers, and basically you just follow the trend when the price is dropping. The main disadvantages of this approach is that sometimes it's very hard to define when a certain trend is exhausted, and if you join the movement on the end, this could cause you some unnecessary and unwanted losses. There are also people who prefer another approach and they are trying to implement trend contrarian strategy. Now I'm going to open again the chart in order to show it to you more easily. What the people that are implementing trend contrarian strategy are doing is that basically they are trying to catch all of these small corrections that I'm showing to you now. This approach is very attractive to some traders, because the movement on the long side especially, usually they are very slow, and the corrections on the short side are developing quickly. So in this way they are trying to catch a quick and in my opinion uncertain winnings. Of course, in this way you can generate winnings faster. However, I don't recommend this approach for beginners traders, because in my opinion it's riskier. Because first of all, it is harder to catch the movements, and second of all, in my opinion, the trades there are with less probability, because you're going against the main movement. Now let's continue with defining the trend, and here what is very important for you to remember is actually something that I told you in the beginning, and this is that for an uptrend you always have to look for higher highs. As you can see, it is very well represented here. The highs are always higher than the previous one. And respectively, the lows has to be higher as well. As you can see here, the lows are always higher from the previous one. And in my opinion, in this chart is very well represented. For a downtrend, of course, it is just vice versa. You have to look for lower lows and of course lower highs. Here it is also very important to remember that the impulse and corrections are apart from every trend, and you have to take them under consider. On the next chart, it is very easy for you to observe the impulse and the corrections. They are very well represented here, and of course I want to briefly mention something that I haven't told you yet, and that is in every trend there are of course trends inside of the trends. If you imagine that this whole movement is on a daily time frame, if you remember, we talked about the time frames into the previous lessons. If you go to a lower time frame, let's say 1 hour, there will be very small trends inside of this whole movement, which are represented from this red line here. It is totally up to you. We will prefer to buy and hold for the big movement, or you prefer to trade actively and try to catch every impulse and correction that is appearing on the market. This was everything from today's lesson. I hope you liked it and I hope it was useful for you. If you have any questions, you can leave them into the comment section below, or you can just contact with me directly. I'll respond anyway. Don't forget to subscribe for our YouTube channel and of course to click the little bell, because in this way you're gonna be notified immediately when we post a new video. Thank you very much for your attention and see you again next time. Bye bye.